When it comes to DesignOps maturity, there's both good news and bad news. I'll start with the bad news. For the most part, DesignOps maturity is low. Many organizations are just not at the place where they're dedicating roles or even time to activities meant to elevate the impact and value of design at their organization, which is what DesignOps aims to do. I know this from a survey I conducted with over 500 UX design professionals, where I asked about the state of activities related to the three layers of our DesignOps framework, including how the team works together, how the team gets work done, and how their work creates impact. First, I asked respondents about how they work together, meaning how they communicate, build teams, and enable growth for team members. Less than a third said they have a documented org structure, and worse, only 11% said they were aware of any documented growth paths or career ladders. What's more, 82% of practitioners said that there was no way to advance in their career without becoming a people manager at their company. Okay. Then I asked them about how they get their work done efficiently and effectively, meaning how they share insights and resources, standardize processes, and prioritize work. Here, only 17% reported having a documented design process. Only 30% felt that design was well integrated into the development process. And less than a third felt that they operated at a comfortable capacity and that projects were reasonably estimated. Finally, I asked them about how their work creates impact, meaning how they track design quality and socialize their successes and their value as a team. Now, if you were hoping it gets better here, it doesn't really. Only 9% of teams were tracking any metrics at all, and only 14% had a consistent way of describing the role and value of design to people outside of their team. That, of course, makes it unsurprising that 80% felt that design's role and value was not understood across their company. Okay, so that's the bad news. What's the good news then? First, we know we can do better. Design teams are acutely aware of this gap in DesignOps, scoring their organizations fairly low overall in DesignOps maturity, and expressing the desire to cultivate DesignOps for their teams. Second, think of the opportunity that exists. These low percentages are a huge opportunity for organizations that want to adopt DesignOps because it won't take much to reach parity or even become best in class. And with the continued growth of the DesignOps community, creating a platform for designers, researchers, and DesignOps professionals to share their experiences, we'll keep learning from each other and elevating our practices, building up these percentages as we do.